Very good morning, students. So in the previous class, we discussed about a combination of lenses, as well as on the basis of combination of lens, we discussed also two problems. And tell you another problem. So from our material only, page number 68. Page number 68, and the question number will be 2.26. I'll read the question. So the carefully listen. Myopic person has been using the spectacles of power of -1.0 diprots for distant vision. During the old age, he also need to use the separate reading glass power of 2. Explain what may have happened. So this is a given question. So the power is given. The first power is given as, that is, will be P is equal to 1D, and by using this you can see the right, so that you get first focal length 1/P. It is 1/D, it is in centimeter, 10^-2. Then focal length will be 100 centimeter. It is clear, which is given as minus. No, this is given minus. No, so that we'll get the minus. It is, and yeah, after that is asking what. When the person distinct vision, sir, what is mean by distinct vision? So the distinct vision is nothing but you remember that will be at a distance of 25 centimeter. See, the person which we can see very clearly image, if the object is at a distance of 25 centimeter, therefore that we can see very clearly, the distance which we can call as the least distinct vision, LDDV, least distance of distinct vision. So if the object is at a distance of 25 centimeter, therefore we can see clearly the image. So there it is given as the person can see for a distinct vision. So that you take as the object is at a distance of 25 centimeter, so the spectacle power view, so that we can get first object distance by using this. U is equal to given as -25 centimeter. We know f, and we know this one also, which one, power, focal length and u, get 1/f is equal to 1/u minus, like this. So that you substitute these all values, 1/100 is equal to 1/v minus 1/25, it is plus, it is minus. 1/v is equal to, it is 1/25 minus 100. So if you simplify this, 100 minus 25 by, it is approximately 2500. If you take simplification, so that you will get the answer will be approximately -50 centimeter. It is clear. So this is the v value, and here by using this again you should get an f value by using this f and v and u. Again f value will be 1/v minus 1/u. So here it is given, we know the f value -1/50, and here object distance is also minus. No, so that we'll get 1/f is equal to -25 plus 50 by, you take it 25 into 50. Again you simplify this, f is equal to 25 into 50 by, it is 25. So that we'll get the focal length will be -50. It is, look at it is. So now is asking power. No, so that you get a power is equal to, by using this, power is equal to 100/f. Then power is equal to 100 by, it is given as 50. So it is approximately 2D, 2 diprots or meter inverse. So like this way, the power calculation will be there. And in the same page number, there was another question is there. You're supposed to do that problem example 2.24. This is the homework. 2.24 is the homework. So the same page number, 68 is the page number. 68 is the page number. So that you're supposed to do this problem, then it is a practice for you. Clear? So this is related to the combination of lenses. So now lenses theory is completed. Lenses theory is completed. Now let us move to the next one. That is about a prism related. See, there is a prism. I think everyone know about a prism. So generally, by using a prism, now we have to find the refractive index of a given prism. Yeah, prism concept. Now let us, I'll explain you. When a light is propagating, through the prism. White light is enters through the prism. Therefore, the light is divided into 7 colors. Clear? Dividing 7 colors is nothing but we can call as a spectrum, because that forms a 7 colors Vibgr. It is in the order of Vibgr. We'll see in the Vibgr, and again it is there dispersion, angular dispersion. It is there different things are there. Before that, now we are discussing about a prism related. Here, in case of a prism, there is a question is there in our material that is for given as 4 marks question. See the page number 46. I'll explain the question. It is a for 4 marks question. See, 4 marks question it is. Clear? And here it is given in the page number. It is question number is 1 and page number is 46. Look at you. I'll explain the question properly. Then after we'll see. See, when you take a prism, the prism is minimum deviation position. You know everything, everyone know about a prism. The prism is actually have a 3 refracting surfaces. It is in the form of a rectangle. See, 3 refracting surfaces, prism. Like lens, actually we have 2 refracting surfaces. Like in the same way, prism also have 3 refracting surfaces, which is in the form of a equilateral triangle. Let I'll give you, you take a prism like this, right? It is an equilateral triangle, so that the angle of prism will be 60 degree, because it is equilateral, that we can say any 2 refracting surfaces, because it is 1 refracting surface, this is another refracting surface, and this is the 3rd refracting surface. You can use any manner, use any manner. Therefore, all are the refracting surfaces only, so that the angle between the any 2 refracting surface will be 60 degree. Angle between the any 2 refracting surface is equal to 60 degree. That's what we can call angle of prism. So that for angle of prism is 60 degree it is. So you take a, like it is a prism which is placed like this. So use a, it is A, B, C is the equilateral prism. A, B, C is the equilateral prism. Let us, here now we have to find the refractive index of a prism. Sir, what is refractive index? Actually sin I by sin R, right? In this case, what we have to find? We have to find the I and R. After getting I and R, therefore you substitute in the value of a refractive index, mu is equal to sin I by sin R. Let us, suppose you take a, when a white light or a light ray is propagating from, it is a rare R medium, of course we can say it is a rare R, it is a dense R, again it is rare R. So light is propagating from one medium to another medium. You draw a one normal on the refracting surface, any refracting surface, that's what I mean. You take this refracting, or you take this refracting, or this you. So when the rays enters, light rays enters like this, it is a ray which we can say P, Q, and here when it is incident angle is you say I. Very simple here. Here it is when the normal we can say it is. Therefore, if you extend a normal like this, clear? If I extend a normal to be like this, so that it is maybe normal will be like this. Okay, so that it is an incident angle. Then it is when propagating from rare R to dense R medium, of course the ray which bends towards a normal, yes, it is a ray, it is a refracted ray, and which making an angle, refraction angle is R1. Clear? And it is again it is enters, and it is propagating from glass medium to again into the another, that we will get the emergent ray. So that which making, again you draw a one more normal here. If you extend a like this, it is making a like this. So the ray when propagating from dense R to rare R medium, therefore the ray which bends away from like this. So which we can call as the emergent angle, E is equal to I2 we can say. So that there is a principle of reversibility also it is obvious. If the ray which propagated like this also, same it is goes. Yes, it is comes out like this. So we can take here I1, you say it is I2, both will be the same. So here you can take a one more. So that here you say it is the angle of here the normal 2, and it is a normal 1 which making an angle R2. Suppose incident ray is extended and the refraction ray is extended, which makes an angle deviation D. The deviation will be represented as like this. We can say here it is I1 minus R1, which we can say I1 minus R1. See, look at I1 minus R1, this one. We can take like this, I1 minus R1. This is also represented as actually I2 minus R2, or you can say E minus R2 also, no problem. Your wish it is E minus R2 or you want to write here I2 minus R also, nothing will happen. That is the deviation. So the deviation will be like this, I1 minus R1 plus I2 minus R2, we can take as a deviation, so that we can say like this. Now let us will use the, there is any quadrilateral triangle is there, A, Q, you say it is a P something, okay, it is you take as a R it is, right, you say it is S. So there is a quadrilateral triangle, A, Q, R, S is the quadrilateral triangle. Or else you want to take from our material whatever the notations are given, yes, it is better for you also. So that I'll give you directly A, Q, of course R and S. It is very clear given. So this you take a point P it is, and here it is given as M letter. This is given as the T letter. Better use these letters, and it is also help you for the calculation also. So that you take a quadrilateral triangle, from quadrilateral triangle A, Q, R, S. A, Q, R, S is the quadrilateral triangle. Sir, what will be the quadrilateral triangle? See, the quadrilateral triangle is nothing but angle A plus, here another triangle is there, you take an angle of Q, R, S. Q, R, S is equal to 180 degree. This is using a quadrilateral triangle, angle A plus angle of Q, R, S. This is the one related to the angle of A plus angle of Q, R, S. And you take as the from an angle, that is also you take a triangle from triangle, that is we can say QRS. You take a QRS is a triangle, therefore angle R1 plus angle R2 plus, here we have angle of QRS is equal to again 180, because sum of the triangle, sum of the angles in a triangle will be how much, it is 180 degree. So that here we'll get from 1 and 2, you take equation 1 and 2. This is you take a 1 and 2, because of course 180, 180 is there, equal it R1 plus R2 plus QRS is equal to, it is angle A plus angle QRS. So better this cancel, therefore R1 plus R2 is equal to angle A, or A is equal to R1 plus R2. You keep as equation 3. Now we know A is finished. Now you take a deviation, that is a deviation is nothing but a instant ray is extended and a refractor ray is extended, the angle we can call as a deviation. So that the deviation will be D is equal to I1 minus R1 plus, here it is E minus R2, or else you want to write I2 also, no problem. Yes, it is D is equal to I1 minus R1 plus I2 minus R2. Therefore, deviation D is equal to I1 plus I2 minus R1 plus R2. You write like this, because here minus is there, now you take a common, but we know from here, we know from 3, you take it is 4 as, from 3, that is A is equal to R1 plus R2 is there, no, D is equal to, here you write I1 plus I2 minus capital A. This is you give as a equation 5. Now we know deviation, and we know R1 and R2, A angles also we know, clear. Now according to the actually deviation, we can say the angle of incidence are equal. When will we get the equal angle of incident? I'll tell you that deviation. See, by using the deviation and angle of incident, you draw a one graph. The graph will be very, very important. So, which is useful for your practical examination also. Look at. So, the graph will be, graph is taken like this. Graph, which is for a deviation and incident angle. Suppose I'll tell you graph. So, the deviation is taken on this, and incident angle is taken on x-axis. This is there in the practicals also. In practicals, we have to prove this. See, suppose if the angle of incident is increases, very simple, angle of incident increases, deviation also increases. Suppose if it is an angle of incident is at a position of this one, therefore the deviation will be like this. Like angle of incident is increases, therefore deviation also increases. Gradually it is increases, and at a particular angle of incident, see, when reaches to that particular angle of incident, that we can say one reaches to the minimum position, after reaching minimum what will happen, that is again the angle of incident is increases. See, first increases, then after again it is decreases, then after that what happens, and it reaches to the minimum position, at a minimum will be what happens, R1 is equal to R2 is equal to R2. At this position I1 is equal to I2 is equal to I. See, here it is about a like angle of deviation and refraction. This point which we can call as a minimum deviation. So we can say delta is equal, d is equal to delta m, which we can write like this. At any minimum deviation, that is I1 is equal to I2 is equal to I, R1 is equal to R2 is equal to R, at that particular angle of incident, therefore the ray again, the deviation again increases. First increases, then decreases, and it reaches to the minimum. After reaching minimum, again what happens? Again it is increases gradually. This position which we can call as the minimum deviation. The prism is now in minimum deviation. Let us actually, we have these values, suppose to write here, and delta is nothing but a dm, and here R1 is equal to R2 is equal to, you say R. Okay, this is the graph. By using this information, let I'll substitute. Yeah, I'll show you the final expressions will be like this. See, we have the third expression and fifth expression. From third, look at A is equal to R plus R, then A is equal to 2R, then R is equal to A by 2. Like here you take from fifth expression, D is equal to I1 plus I2 minus A, then D is equal to 2I minus A. Clear? This is from here what we can write here, delta, because D is nothing but a delta, no? Minimum deviation, you can also say delta M. 2i minus a, therefore it is 2i is equal to delta m minus a is nothing but a plus, it is then I is equal to delta m plus a by 2. This is I and we know R. Now here the value is there, that is the related to the refractive index of a material of the prism, so that the refractive index of a material of the prism is mu is equal to sin I. Here you write sin I, mu is equal to sin I by sin R. Of course, we know sin I. I is nothing but a mu is equal to sin of delta m plus a by 2 by sin R is nothing but a, you say it is a by 2. This is the refractive index of material of the prism. Refractive index of material of the prism. If you go through this, and it is for 4 marks question in our IPE final examination, suppose you do this, it is help you, right? Okay. And here coming to the point is, some other cases also is there. In case of a prism, sometimes thin angled prism, it may give you thin angled prism. Sir, what is mean by thin angled prism? Thin angle is nothing but angles are very small. Angles are very small, you remember. It is only related to what? Refractive index of a prism it is. So the derivation related to refractive index of a prism, mu is equal to sin of delta m plus a by 2 by sin a by 2. Or we can also say mu is equal to sin of d plus a by 2 by sin of a by 2 we can take. Yes, it is the refractive index of a prism. So in this again we have thin angled prism. There is a question, is there thin angled prism? Sir, what is mean by thin angle? See, angles are very small. Suppose if angles are very small, then what will happen? Yes, look at here, thin angled prism, thin angled prism, right? Thin angled prism, that mean here we know refractive index mu is equal to sin of delta plus a by 2 by sin of a by 2, fine. So here it is, the angles are very small, no? So that you take here sin of delta plus a by 2, which almost equal to delta plus a by 2, or your sin a by 2, no, you take as it is a by 2 you take. Now you replace these values at a mu, in a given a mu, then what will happen? We'll see. So that you take like this, mu is equal to sin a plus delta a by 2 is nothing but a delta plus a by 2 by sin a by 2 is nothing but a by 2 you take. So it is 2 cancelled, mu is equal to delta plus a by a. So cross multiply, mu a is equal to delta plus a. This a, take this side, mu a minus a is equal to delta. So delta is equal to minimum deviation. Delta is equal to, you take a is common, mu minus 1 into a. So here we can write here a is the angle of prism, therefore delta directly proportional to mu minus 1. That minimum deviation is depends on refractive index. Minimum deviation is depends on refractive index. So this is the thin angled prism related. Clear? And here if you go through this, there is one problem is there in our material, that is for 2 marks question, which is very very important. Usually from this chapter they will ask you one question also on the basis of this one. Yeah, so this question was given in the 2015, okay, in our IPE examination on the basis of thin angled prism. So that I'll tell you that question also. Clear? Yeah, look at the question, I'll read you first. So the question, page number, related to the thin angled prism, and related to the prism also we have other problems, so that also we'll discuss. So before that I'll tell you this, the thin angled prism, because it is important for 2 marks. This was question was it is given in the previous IPE exam. Right. Coming to the question, page number 45, question number is 8. Page number 45, question number is 8. Yeah, look at, a small angled prism of 4 degree deviates. So the angle of prism is how much is given? It is given as a small angle, not equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle is nothing but a 60 degree, but it is not given a 60 degree, no. It is given as angle of prism is 4 degree. Deviates a ray through, how much a deviation is taken? The deviation will be delta m, or you say delta, or you want to say d, is given as 2.48 degree. Find the refractive index of the prism, is asking mu. Question was very easy, therefore delta is equal to, we can take as mu minus 1 into a, is asking mu. So delta is given 2.48, mu minus 1 into a will be 4 degree, so that 2.48 by 4 is equal to mu minus 1. Yes, of course we should simplify this, like you take 400 mu minus 1. So what will happen if you simplify this? I think it is 2 ones, yeah, you cancel this, 1s, 2s, 4, and it is 200s. So 124 by 200, fine, mu minus 1 you take, again 6, 2, here it is 100s. So 62, 100, it is mu minus 1. Of course we can take directly, it is 0.62, right? Okay, 0.62 it is. 0.62 is equal to mu minus 1. Mu is asking, no, you take this side, 1 plus 0.62. So mu is equal to 1.62 is the refractive index of the given thin angled prism. For the given thin angled prism will be, refractive index will be like this. Right? Here. On this basis, again we have other problems also, that I'll tell you the problems which related to the prism related in our material given. So the question numbers also I'll tell you. Suppose you do practice, if not also I'll tell you the next class. So the question numbers on the basis of this one. I'll also tell you, no problem, but before that you do the practice. So in the next class I'll discuss this all problems. Yeah, page number 54, question number is 2. Page number 54, question number is 2. You do practice. Page number 54, question number 2 is the one question practice for the practice. And the next page, some related to the same this refractive index, 59 page number, 59 page number, question number 2.6. It is a prism is made of a glass of unknown refractive index. That you do practice. Page number 59, question number 2.6. Right? Yeah, in the same way, 67 page number. Page number 67, 2.22. 2.22 question. 2.22 question. So this is the practice purpose which I was given these questions. So you do it. Otherwise, also I'll tell you in the next class. This is the today's class. And thank you very much. We'll see in the next class. Thank you.